no one narration where Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha complain about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that she's not happy that her husband. But we are people out in speaker's corner, 2019, they think they have a right to speak on her behalf. So my question to ask them, do you have an email from Aisha to tell you to speak on her behalf? Why do you think, why you have this mentality that you think you have a right to speak on someone's behalf even though they are happy? Like America, you know America? America, Iraqi, they were happy. But America believe, no, they're not happy. God has gone help them. They never ask if they are happy, leave them alone. You know, you understand? People like to get involved in people's kitchens. Clean your own kitchen first, then go clean people's kitchens. Okay, so my question to you, are you Christian?
Orthodox.
Orthodox Christian.
Big
you know
up.
What they say?
Big up.
If your house is built out of glass, do not put the stone outside, you know, because you break on yourself. Do you think it's right to keep children? So when your God said to you, to Samuel, to kill a baby, to slaughter them alive, do you think what God did was right?
Telling
my human judgment, no. Just my, but isn't he your God as well?
No, no, before you ask me if he's my God or not, first of all, of course I believe in the same God, but I don't believe those passages. I don't believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to our prophet, go kill babies and children, slaughter them alive because of a sin that happened 400 years ago. I don't believe that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. Allah will not take you responsible for a sin of someone else. No, he will not take you, put you in the hellfire because something happened. So in Samuel, he says, go kill babies and children. You know why? Because their forefathers did something to Jacob. So my question to you, do you think that was right from God to do that?
It's not me to question God's judgment.
So it's not for you, but it's for you to question God, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. Muhammad, the Prophet, was a man. So
Samuel was a man. Was he an awesome man?
I'm not saying it was right, but he did.
Yeah, but God told him. You believe God ordered you to be evil?
I don't know the whole context. So nah, there's I need to check the verse.
No problem. Also, do you know that in the Bible, Moses was ordered, Moses, according to the Bible, he ordered his soldiers to kill every woman that slept with a man and keep the little girls for yourself. Why? You know Prophet Muhammad said? He said, in a war, not like this coward, they come and put bombs and trains to test the people. No. Prophet said, in a war, do not kill women, do not kill children, do not kill a man in his temple. For example, there's a war and there's someone worshipping Jesus in the church. We're not allowed to go and kill him. You know, I would like to kill those who try to kill us. So look at Prophet Muhammad teaching clear cut. Do not kill the babies. There was one war, battlefield. It's a woman killed. He said, this woman should not, no one should kill her. He said, don't kill women. But you have in your Bible, kill women, kill babies, kill children. Even according to the Bible, if you are a priest and your daughter commit fornication, you know what is the punishment? You burn her alive. Burn her alive. And you come to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
What about if you decide not to be a Muslim?
For God, no. Wait. In the Bible, first of all, in the Bible, God said to Moses, if a person changes religion, stone him to death. Is that right for God to say that?
Today's age, no.
So your God, let me understand you correctly. Your God is outdated, expired.
It's just my belief.
I don't talk about God. I don't know what you believe. I'm talking about God. Was God right?
I'm saying my opinion. I don't represent the whole.
No.
It's just my personal.
When God said kill someone because he changed his religion, was God right or wrong when he said that?
God said.
So we ask him a question then. God said, Christians, if God said alhamdulillah, but if another God, if a Muslim said it, no.
In today's age, I don't believe, no Christian does this because we believe, we follow the new law, the new
Which
testament.
Which is the new law?
Pardon?
Which is new law? Democracy.
No. Christians follow the new testament law, so we don't follow anymore the old testament.
The new testament, Jesus said, I didn't come to abolish the law or the prophet. I came to fulfill it. So
yeah,
Jesus
was completed.
Yeah, finished. Yeah, Jesus came to fulfill the law, not to go against the law. And Jesus said in the Old Testament says, if you look to a woman, it's a sin. Rather, if you look to a woman with desire, take you out your eyes.
okay, but
have you ever looked to the woman with the desire?
Yes.
So how come you still have the eyes? What's happening? You know what's happening now? Now even the Christian be affected heavily. Some Muslims walk. Now because the people changed, okay? So what people are doing, they've been influenced by liberalism, okay, and secularism. So what they're doing, they wanna fit with liberalism and they start changing the teaching of God. No, we are happy with the teaching of God. But God is the most just, the most wise. So when Allah legislates anything in the Quran and the Sunnah, in the tradition, there is a wisdom behind it. And there is what? There's conditions. No, go around, kill everyone. No, you don't do that. You understand? You understand that? In Islam, those who carry out the Islamic legislation, it's not for you or for me or for him. It's for the Muslim authority in a Muslim country, not in Britain, as those foolish guys who say we are here to implement Sharia. These are foolish, because we are here, we are under a government. We are in a non-Muslim country, so we have shown them we're not here to take over and try to force our way. No, we're not here for that. Na'am? We have to be just. My question, let us go to the foundation. You believe in God. And you believe there is a purpose for life. Okay? Is Jesus God?
He's the Son of God.
He's the Son of God. So you don't believe...
Not God himself.
So you don't believe Jesus to be God?
He shared his nature, but he's not God himself. He's the Son of God. So it's different.
Sorry, I'm a bit confused. Is he God or not? That's my question.
Pardon?
Is Jesus God or not?
He's not the one God.
Yeah, you should believe
his
that.
His Son, Orthodox. Right?
His Son.
His Son.
What do you mean by that?
He shared his father nature. He's speaking about God as his father, right?
Yeah, but I'm saying...
He didn't claim he's God himself. He said...
Because what you have to understand, when he says Son of God, in English, we speak in English, correct? In English language, when he says son, son has three meanings. When a man and woman get together, produce a son, or an old man call a young man my son, or a stepson. So which one is it?
So it can be just from this free or?
In English language. Otherwise, it's like me telling you, I have a fridge for you. Then when you come to my house, I give you microwave. Tell me, no, shamsi, fridge is different than microwave, you know? So when you tell me Jesus is Son of God, when you look to English language, son has three meanings. The fourth one, which is the actual son. You speak in English language, don't tell me son means something else. So what does it mean?
This is human language. We can't, you know, portray our human mind, you know. So I'm not saying God had sex with a person and gave birth. So
yeah,
I'm
okay.
Not saying this.
Okay. Now I understand you. So now, are you saying because Jesus never had a father, therefore God is his father?
Yes.
But Adam never had a father and a mother. So who's his father and mother?
Adam was created from clay.
So from clay, okay. But who's his father and mother? No one.
We don't know.
No, he's the first man. No, he's the first man. No one. Okay, now Eve. Eve, she was created Adam. You know? So she came from a man. But there's another thing missing, a woman inside. So who's her mother?
Yes, we have to ask God for this.
So. No, we know what Allah said.
We only know from what we read in the Genesis.
Know what Allah said. Look, Allah wants to show power is a powerful. Because human beings, in order for me to have a baby, I have to have a wife. You know? God wants to show you that He can create human being without need of another human being. You know? So He created Adam. There's no any human being. Then God wants to show you He can create a human being from a man without a woman being there. You with me? Which is Eve. Okay? Now God wants to show you He can create another human being from a woman without a man being there. Which is who? Jesus. So none of them are children of God. We are the servants of God. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا. The people, the Christians and the Arab pagans, they said God had son. لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا. You came with the most evil statement. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتِ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا أَنْ دَعَوْا لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدًا. Allah said, if Allah allows the heavens and the earth to show their feeling concerning this statement that God has a son, the sky will split asunder and the earth will split asunder and the mountain will tend to crumble. Allah said it's not befitted for the most beneficent to have a son. You know why? Because God is God and human being. Understand? We are what? We are the creation of God. That's why I believe in Jesus, mighty messenger. mighty prophet without any doubt. He knows. How are you doing?
They love Jesus.
Without any doubt, as a Muslim, you have to.
Yes,
however, I believe that the tissue of Jesus, our mighty messenger, has been played with. You know? And you can see many things which doesn't make any sense.
But even if it's played, it's only about positive things. So even if you believe this, it can't do you harm.
Okay, the question I will ask you, do you think the most wise God, the most just God, would he leave us with a book that is mixing the truth and the falsehood, or would he clarify the truth to us?
What is the falsehood?
No, I'm asking, what would he? Would he leave us with a falsehood mixing the truth, or he will clarify the truth to us? You will clarify the truth to us, okay?
Yes.
So now when I told you about there is some stuff in Jesus' teaching or being ascribed to Jesus on the Bible, which doesn't make any sense. You said, no, you have to think about the positive thing. Yeah, but the Bible, the passages there, all of them claim to be from God. God will never leave us with that. God will send another prophet, another teaching. That's why I believe Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came into the picture. He came with a teaching, worship one God. Believe in Jesus, Moses. You know, there is many ways to show you Prophet Muhammad was not a false prophet. Why? If Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam, his main target is to gain more followers, when he was in Medina, what he would have done, he would have defended Jews and said to them, yeah, you're right, Jesus was a bastard. But rather, what did he do? He said, no, you're liars. Jesus was not a bastard. So there was no need for Prophet Muhammad to defend Jesus in Medina if he was a false prophet, because he's looking for followers. To show you Prophet Muhammad had no authority over the Quran. Whatever Allah tell him to say, he said it. So he defended Jesus in a time, there was no need for Prophet Muhammad to do that. You with me? No, you with me?
No, we'll have a conversation another time.
Alright, yeah.
The man calling. No, he's okay. A good man.
So, what? It makes sense. You know why? If I want followers, especially if I'm in Britain, I want to get followers, I will say anything to please the British people. I want them to follow me.
Wait, what's the tribe of Quraishi and...
No, he refused them. He said, you're God's false God. How he did? He didn't please them.
But he did please them.
How? Show me.
There's a story where he went with them and he said, you can pray to your God and they will...
That story is fabricated. False story.
And talk about
the Gharaniya Qalula, which is the Prophet Muhammad was reciting the verse, and then he said something, or Shaitan said something, so all of the prostrate. That's for a fabricated story. From Albani, one of our scholars died in the Sports Hadith, he said that story is a fabricated story. Prophet Muhammad.
But you heard this?
No.
One thing with Shamsi is he will fast for you tonight so that the truth will become more plain.
I will not fast
for you. He will fast for you tonight. Like you wouldn't believe if he loves you, he'll fast for you. And God will put the truth in your
Inshallah.
Mind. Don't let God down.
No.
Yes, Colin.
What I'm saying, Colin is a funny guy. What I'm saying, look, me, study. I'm Muslim, but I read the Bible. I study. Why? Because Islam knowledge is the key. Knowledge is very important. Don't repeat, you seem like a smart man, you know? But don't repeat everything they say about Prophet Muhammad. And then, alayhi salam, there is many ways to prove Prophet Muhammad is a true prophet. And Islam is a true religion. And Quran is the word of Allah. Without any doubt.
Everyone says this, you know, come to my team, this is the right, you know. Catholics say, come to us.
Yeah, but you
have everyone says, come
okay.
to us.
Tell me about it, yeah?
Thanks for joining just now.
How a man lived 1400 years ago,
Shamsi, big up there,
prophesizing about the future. Not just prophesizing about the future, likewise coming with a book, which within the book, he says, no, he conveyed, Allah said, yeah? That this book, which is Quran, it would be easy to memorize it. You with me, please? It would be easy to memorize it. There is no book on the face of the earth, it's been memorized by 100 million of people, except the Quran. The Jewish, the Torah is very special to them. The Christian, the New Testament is very special to them. But how come it's the only book that has been memorized, word by word, letter by letter, is the Quran? Why? What is special about this book?
Memorized by...
You tell me, by Muslims, children, 5 years old, 7 years old. You know, Algeria, the youngest, memorized the Quran, 4 years old.
How many pages?
And how many pages Quran? 700. Word by word, letter by letter. Sometimes there are Europeans and Africans who doesn't speak Arabic language, but they memorize an Arabic language word by word. And if it's a book like this, therefore, will never be changed. You know why? Example now, if I write A, E, O, D, I can change it. But everyone here, based upon memorization, can know it's A, B, C, D, E, F. Yeah? But that's what the Quran. You know, that look teaching Prophet Muhammad. I don't want to just be like a repeat stuff. Here, this subject for me as a gift, please. Here, please. Yeah, this is our website there. Where are you from?
Where I live?
Yeah. Where are you?
More.
On the outside. I'm from Chile. You know, so you have our website. Please, if you want to meet up, you can stop.
I'm not about converting. I'm not saying you should convert necessarily. In my opinion, I believe religion.
Of course, I'm converting because me, I care about you. So if I care about you and I love something for you, I'm not going to force you, but I will show you with intellectual proofs, tangible proofs, what Islam is the truth. Why Prophet Muhammad is the true prophet,
converting, I don't think it's enough just so you can convert and that's it.
No, you have to implement.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. 2 days ago, Englishman became Muslim in our mosque, in Istanbul. I spoke to him 2 weeks ago, and he was like, you know, I said, become Muslim. He said, not that time. He said, give me 2 weeks. I said, you know, you never know you're going to die. Alhamdulillah, he came back, started last Friday, and he took shahada. So you never know. Study me, because you're going to die. Allah in the Quran said to Umm Muhammad, the death that you run away from, surely will meet you. And you return to Allah, and Allah will judge you. God gave us intellect, brain. Let us utilize it. Why there is not, where is Christianity, Judaism, Islam? That's the main religions. Why all of them claim to be a follower of Abraham, but they differ with one another? Why? But for example, the Old Testament, God regrets. That's not God. God doesn't regret. Regret when you don't know the outcome of something.
Now I got you. So you believe in the same God, God from the Old Testament. So
yeah, but I believe
it's different. You're saying it's
not God. No, why? I believe the same God. However, I believe there's many things that have been attributed to God in the Bible which is not true.
So the Torah is not accurate.
Not all of it. There's some truth in it, without any doubt, but not every.
How can you distinguish?
The Quran is a criteria for me. Even put the Quran aside, even your intellect and natural inclination. You know, for example, God regrets. That's not God's nature. That's not God's attribute to regret. When you regret, when you don't know the outcome of something, that's why you regret. You know what I'm talking about? When he said God looked upon the earth and he regretted that he created mankind. That's not God's speech. No. No. But read those leaflets, please. And if you have any questions, I'm here. You can come back. All right? All right. Well, it's not safe for you, man. Look out to yourself.